When is that again? The next GDQ? I totally forgot. I know it's coming soon, isn't it? It usually depends on my mood leading up to it. Like, there have been years I'm actually really looking forward to AGDQ or SGDQ. And then there's years where, like, I'm just not feeling it and I don't really watch much. I'm not really excited for it. It's the 6th of next month, so July the 6th. I should be able to watch most of it. Depends if I have to work. If I have to work during most of it and I miss most of what I want to watch, and I'm probably not going to be that hyped for it. Rip that room, dude. I actually got the fast kit. Just not feeling it today. Not gonna get a run. Life just doesn't want me to do it, man. Just doesn't want me to do it. For those at home who are worried, I'm not dying. That was a hiccup. I was about to call the paramedics. I might have not pushed that enough. Wow, it was. Sometimes you can actually not push that enough, even with a ninth push. Sometimes if you wait, you push it too much, it's really picky. Using that bad angle, that wouldn't have worked. This time's gonna suck. It's gonna be like a 759 spade key. Nice one, Licker. You did real good. Nice job. Please, game, don't be a dick. Let me make it past the zombie. This better be a world record run or I'll slit your throat. Holy fuck. I better world record then. Shit. I'll try my best, man, but please have mercy. I don't know, I can only do so good. Oh, that was really good. Whoa! Almost knocked my drink over. I'm just knocking things over all over the place. Woohoo! Born fuck up. Alright, this is probably my last run. Yeah, this is my last run no matter what happens. 100% ran. ATTQ. ATTQ. Okay, dokily. Let's do it. Final run, let's go. Let's go! This is the world record. Don't get my throat slit. A smiley face for that. Like, I'm gonna slit your throat, guys. Smiley face. Also, that's about as like perfect as that room can get, by the way. That's really good. Oakley-dokley, neighborinos. Nice one, Licker. You're like really good at this game. You really got me hard there, man. Bullshit! Fuck this game, man. Fuck this game. Fucking kill me, man. Fucking kill me.
Thank you.
Yeah, the hallway's a bitch. If I just didn't get bit at that area before Mervin, I would have been fine. Either the woman or the filing room. Like, one less bite in this run would be good. As long as one of the little embryo of the creatures from the boss doesn't latch onto me and grab me and put me to caution, the next split should be fine. I should be able to make up time for the rest of the run. So as long as this boss goes good and those things don't grab onto me. No, it put me the yellow caution. Now I have to use the first aid spray. Oh well. Those spiders are determined, man. Cool. Oh yeah, I forgot. I have a new strat for the final boss. I totally forgot. I have a new strat for the final boss that can potentially save over 10 seconds if it goes good. I totally forgot about my final boss strat. I came out with a few nights ago. So yeah, even if I keep on pace and get a bit ahead, and then good boss, I can PB by over 10 to 15 seconds, maybe 20. I have to go to the washroom really bad. I gotta pee, man. I have to urinate. But I have to wait 10 minutes. Hard boss. Hard. The hardest of all bosses I've ever lived. Go to the bathroom really bad. All right, that was perfect. Favorite controller of all time? Probably Super Nintendo. Yeah, favorite controller of all time is almost definitely the Super Nintendo controller. What about yours? Pronounce GameCube controller wrong. Actually, I really do like the GameCube controller. It does have some flaws though, so it wouldn't be my favorite. But I do really like it. A lot of people hate on it. The Atari 5200. Atari 5200 controller. Yeah, I can totally like see how GameCube would be people's favorite chaos. I think GameCube is a really good controller too as well. It's very close. But I just have to go Super Nintendo. Yeah, the NES is also very nice. Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me right now? Okay, I can take that. The rest went perfect, so I can take that. Oh shit, I was supposed to split. Fuck. I always split late on that now. Yeah. I'm very busy and focused. I can't really pay attention to what you're talking about.
Is that can empty?
No, it's not. Yes, the new strat worked. I got the new boss strat. Bam! Save like 10 seconds. It stops him from jumping up on the like tanker things up top, and you kill him before he jumps up in 2 hits. Boom. Fuck, man. That run can probably still be about 20 seconds faster. 20 to 30 with a perfect run. Alright, so spade key, 4 seconds, that can be four. There's 4 seconds there. That was really good. Lost time there. Yeah, probably about close to 10 seconds overall. The croc, yeah, the croc can still be about 5 to 6 seconds better, I believe. So that's about 16 seconds. Between enter lab, that was really good. Just keep it. I got bit by that zombie, it can be faster. Let's say 18 seconds. I also got hurt by that bug earlier in the sewer, I forgot, so let's say 20 seconds. And then after the mode disc, that boss fight was really good. 20. I'd say 25 seconds can be taken off of this. Thank you, Chaos. Thank you, Aiden. Thank you, Scoop. Thank you, Orphan. Thank you, everyone. Now, recently I was deciding the most of the records, basically all the records for this game are kept by in-game timer, and that's what I'm running by, and that's what my PB is, the 10217 in-game time. And I discovered recently, I already knew this for years, there's a trick to this game where the game doesn't let you skip the ending cutscene and the credits, the one on the train and this one, as you can see I'm pressing it, and it wouldn't have worked on the other one. Now, if you eject the disc from your Wii or GameCube and put it back in, it will actually skip the cutscene. And then you can do the same for the credits, although I don't think the credits factor into the time, but I think the final cutscene on the train does. And there's actually a trick, it actually does count to the in-game timer, so if you take out the disc as soon as the cutscene starts and put it back in, it takes close to a minute off the in-game timer, 40-ish to a minute. It's a bit inconsistent. I tested this years back, and I swear there wasn't a difference, but I tested again recently, and there is. I tested to make sure a bunch of times in a row. And ejecting the disc and putting it back in to skip that cutscene does take like 40 seconds to a minute off the in-game timer. So I was wondering recently if that should be allowed in the run to take off the in-game timer, because it's like skipping cutscene, but it's not, the game didn't intend you to skip that. So I ultimately decided recently to not allow that and just take the 40 second time loss and just, because that's, nobody else does that anyways, and I'm pretty sure it'd be frowned upon. So my old PB was 10209. And with this run, if I took the disc and put it back in, I probably could have gotten a really low 101 or maybe sub 101. But I'm not using that trick. I've decided against it, like, ultimately now to not do that, so. 1 of 2 17, so 30 off. This will probably be a 101-40-ish, unless the in-game timer decides to fuck with me. I'm gonna guess 101-43. 101-56. Damn. So as you can see, I only PB by 21 seconds in.